Yo, yo, it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in today. Got two creators in here. Y'all know how we be collabing and rocking on the channel. Now, I don't know what official name they want to call the platform, but I'm going to call it the Serb Room just because it's more catchy for the city and shit like that. But she has another name that she calls. What is it?
The Red Light Boulevard Show.
Red Light Boulevard?
Yes.
Red Light Boulevard.
Red Light Boulevard Show. Shout out to the Red Light Boulevard Show. We going to call it the Serb Room for the channel tonight. Introduce yourselves to the people, let them know who y'all is, where y'all from, and things like that.
So I'm Kiki Uru from the Red Light Boulevard Show, the Blue Sky Radio, African born and raised. I came out here, been out here for like 10 years. I just started with the radio since last year, man. So okay. We just closed the year.
Man, I'm Dijon, you know what I'm saying? The man behind the server room. Been doing this radio shit for probably like the last 3-4 years.
Oh, that's what's up. That's what's up, man. So, like, you know, we knocked out a collab, man. So, y'all being in Houston and doing this and you doing it for years and years, longer than I have been doing media shit. For sure, I've been in it for like 2 and some change, maybe going on 2.5 now. You know, in Houston, dog, we be talking about this shit, like the challenges of this game. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What are y'all, what is y'all, like, main thing y'all see in what y'all do in the problem in Houston as far as connecting with the artists and getting the artists to understand the importance of media, maybe, or whatever? I don't know if y'all are money, and do y'all try to get money off this, or, like, what y'all on? Like, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you know, it's definitely a business, and with business, we definitely getting paid, you know what I'm saying? Not saying that we out here getting rich off of doing interviews and then like that, but the possibilities are out there to do that. But at the same time, you can't just do it for the love of the money, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's like, you gotta wanna do this because it's a lot that come with it. We just talked about that. You gotta edit interviews, you gotta pull up, you gotta show up, you gotta show out, and you really gotta put on for your city, and you gotta wanna see these artists make it, you know what I'm saying? So, like, the only difficult thing to me really is just, man, like, what's your most difficult part?
Okay, so first things first. One of the reasons why we actually collabed was because I was having my own issues. And, like, being in the industry right now for a year, it's, like, a lot. I wasn't expecting it to be this crazy. Like, you think that shit is just going to come to you. It doesn't. Like, you have to go out there and hustle for it. Like I said, I'm not from out here. I don't have that many connections. I've always been the quiet type. Like, I woke up feeling like, hey, I love this for some reason, like watching podcasts and stuff like that. So I was like, I'm just going to pursue it. But it takes a lot of work. So the hardest thing is definitely connections for me. Like, finding artists and booking interviews. That was like one of the hardest things for me. And so I linked up with Dijon, and that's actually the easiest
thing. And it was hard for me to speak on the difficulties because, like, the way I started off, I was an artist before anything. You know what I'm saying? So, like, starting off, like, I was in the hood, like, you know what I'm saying, for, like, the last probably, like, 12 years I've been standing fifth floor. So I was always around, like, Jay Prince and like, all these different people. So when it came to do the radio show, like, you know what I'm saying, like, my second episode, I had Pow Wow, June James, and Lil O.
Okay.
So then, like, my third episode, I had, like, Lil Flip, and I don't even know who was with Flip. Then I had B King, I had Just Britney. And, like, it took off like that. So, like, doing the radio at the time in 2016, it wasn't really nobody doing it. So, to reach out and get these interviews, it wasn't hard at all. Okay. Now, it's a different story because you got so many people reaching out to these artists to get these interviews.
Yeah.
Back then, it was, like, me and, like, I don't even know.
Maybe, like, 2 or 3 people.
Yeah,
like,
it wasn't even a lot.
It wasn't as much media. I think everybody trying to jump in media right now. And,
yeah.
And artists, they got to pick and decide. Or they feel like they got to pick and decide instead of just saying, you know, I'm going to hit everyone just when the time is right. You know what I'm saying? But I get what you're saying. Like, back then, 2016.
Yeah, it wasn't a lot of people doing it.
Wasn't a lot of people trying to create content.
In 2017, I was doing the radio for, like, 3 or 4 months. I started doing it, like, October. In, like, March, I won Radio Personality of the Year, like, in 3 months. Not because I feel like I was the Radio Personality of the Year, but we were just running interviews, you know what I'm saying? Like, my mind state was Breakfast Club because that's who was doing something similar to what I was doing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, linking up with her, it just made it even better because we here, you know what I'm saying? And, like, she worked hard, she put in work. Like, she just almost ran the whole interview we just did with you. She asked questions. She ain't scared to say what's on her mind. So that's like perfect collaboration for me because we think similar, but we very different.
Yes, 100%. And that's why I fucks with him so hard. This is the African-owned radio that I'm in right now. So it's more out there than it is out here. And that's what I meant when I was talking about connections, because I don't have them. And he has them. Okay. However, I'm super hardworking. And so he's super hardworking. So we were just like, fuck it, we just gonna link up and make it do what it do.
Thanks. Relationships can go farther than hard work sometimes. You know, if you got the relationships and you ain't working hard, it's going to show eventually. But relationships can put you in them positions to show your work and your skill, man. I really realized it in the game because I really thought coming in myself that if I did 15 interviews and I put them on my Instagram page and show that I got 15 interviews, I could hit up anybody and they'll be like, let's work. Same. But that is absolutely not the fucking case. Like,
and what helped me out is just like having those like certain names and then just building a reputation off of that, like instantly booking another interview. Like I put out a Lil Flip interview. So I instantly go hit up like B King, like, hey look, I had Lil Flip on there yesterday, bro. You should be my next guest. And like just knowing that they got likewise people on there with them, it make them more open and want to come through and rock with you.
Yeah, facts. You gotta find a way to like, you know, have a niche with it.
But you gotta stay on it too, you know what I'm saying? Cause I like, it's like an everyday process. Like, I'm always in everybody inbox trying to see what's going down, how we can link up, what we got to, like, every day, every hour of the day.
I recently myself just sat back and was like, man, you know what? I didn't say I'm going to stop hitting up artists, but I said, you know what? I'm going to fall back on trying to reach out to every artist as much and said, I'm going to just keep building a platform how it go. And I'm going to go travel a little bit more and then come back and do that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But it's always love with the artist, man. Not 100%. Everybody. Yeah, every artist not going to see you. You got those ones who are being fake. You know, it's always fuck them. But you know what I'm saying? Because you might, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you just really being on some bullshit as an artist. But I don't expect the artist to be, oh, man, you should know who Urban Politicians is. Nah, it ain't that. You know what I'm saying? At all. But, you know, talk about some of the big names y'all had on here too. Like,
oh my God! First off, topic of discussion, and I'm gonna say this.
Shout out to
you. Those are my bitches. Oh my God, I love them. When that's like the interview that I absolutely got. See, I'm getting tongue tied again because I got super starstruck when I saw them.
Topic of discussion. They used to be called Blush.
Okay.
They was talking to Matthew Knowles.
And now they're topic of discussion. They be having like some controversial lyrics, and they're LGBTQ like myself.
Okay.
So it was definitely awesome meeting them. Yella Yella too, for sure.
Man, shout out Yella Yella. That was a dope interview.
Yes.
But we haven't really like here, you know what I'm saying? We haven't really, because we started off, how we end up linking up together. Well, we've been doing like radio together for probably like the last year. But how we just really got it kicked off, like me and her doing a real show together. She just had an idea. She was like, hey, look, let's just like for like 3 weeks straight, just do free interviews and just interview like up and coming artists. And I was like, you know what? That'll really bring some recognition because for free, niggas gonna pull up. Yeah. So when she had that idea, you know what I'm saying? We ran them 3 weeks, phone still, hey, bro, how can I get an interview? Yeah. How can I get an interview? So I was like, fuck it, we gonna like combine a certain room with your shit. And we're going to get these artists to come through here for real. We're going to get these names in here. Yeah. We're going to do some major shit. So, like really, right now, we about to start doing that. Like,
we're about to rebrand.
We're going to have a new name in a little bit.
Yes, because it's a lot. It's a lot. The Red Light Blue Light Show, Times the Syrup Room, it's a lot. So, we definitely going to rebrand and, like, do this thing for real, because we didn't expect it to be, like, together for this long. Like, it was gonna be like a 3 week thing, and then
because the site room is actually a whole team, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And they not like, my team not mad at me or upset that I'm over here, because my team rock with her too, you know what I'm saying? Like, so it's all good, it's all love, and you know what I'm saying, it's on a need to be basis. Like, I hit DJ 713, he gonna pull up and hop right here and go hard, you know what I'm saying? Or I fuck with whoever, you know what I'm saying? Koyo. Like, just my team, like, we still down, but right now, we see the bigger picture right now. So
that's live, man. Go get game, go create with other people, then, you know, everybody. I feel like people just got to understand that and not be selfish and understand, like, man, if a man got an opportunity, he can go eat, or go get food out and bring it back, you know what I'm saying, whether it's information or relationships or anything, man.
Because everybody ain't going to rock with you, especially when you moving for the better. A lot of people ain't don't want to see you make the moves. They're going to try to do whatever they can. Hey, bro, I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think you should be working with her. Like, just all kind of shit, you know what I'm saying?
You ain't lying. Yeah.
But I'm truly passionate about this, you know what I'm saying? This is what I love. This is the only thing I fucking love. Okay. So it ain't gonna be nobody that can come through and tell me, yo, you need to stop doing this. It's not gonna happen.
Gotcha. I feel that. So with the Houston rap scene right now, man, how do y'all feel about the Houston rap scene? Like I say, I know you're not from here originally, but how do you feel about the Houston rap and music scene right now?
I've been learning a lot from him. I've been learning a lot from even yourself. Like, you know, once you be in this industry, you tap into interviews, you tap into artists. I'm definitely feeling the mixers that we've been having. The rap game has been lit to me thus far. Like, I don't know that many artists, but the ones I know are super lit. Like, the ones that we was talking about, you know, Sauce Walker and them, like, fired. Rappers, including the females, I feel like the females right now are doing their thing in Houston, and that's something that wasn't happening like 2 years ago. You know what I'm saying? That's something that I can definitely appreciate. But yeah, that's me.
Yeah, man. Same thing. Like, man, I grew up like OG Houston rap scene from Ghetto Boys, like Devin the Dude, like Phil Ford Boys. You know what I'm saying? And like being in a position to where I've been able to link up with them, meet these people, see how they work, see how they move. It just give me a whole new perspective on Houston rap scene, because, like, I see how hard these artists work, you know what I'm saying? And I do see them reaching out to younger artists. I know a lot of artists, they got songs with, like, the OGs and stuff like that. And even the younger generation, like, man, like we were just talking about, it's hard to get recognized. It's a big city. It's the fourth largest city in America.
Yeah.
Man, we got Northside, Southside, Eastside, Westside, Katy, Conroe, Woodlands, Channelview, Baytown, but you starting to see artists from all these different areas get recognition out here. Yeah. So it's just like, man, you might got to put in a little bit of extra work out here in H-Town, but it's worth the work, because once you get a little bit of recognition, you can take that a long way. Like, once the city rock with you, it's locked in.
Yeah. Even as a media personality, it's hard to get recognition out here too, I would say.
Oh, for real, for
people
real.
People be thinking it's easy, but I don't think it's that. It's not what people think. It ain't like, oh, you just get out here and half-ass. Now, if you got the name and the following and the followers on Instagram, you can kind of dib and dabble in it, and it'll be easy for you to connect. And y'all really got it going. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, but like I was saying, like with the Cert Room, man, I don't feel like it's the biggest brand. Yeah. Like, it's every time I walk up to an artist, almost they probably didn't hear me, or they probably have. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, like, I'm out here in the streets. Like, I put in a lot of work. Like, every day I'm doing something. Like, I be reaching out to, like, somebody send me like a YouTube, or I just be on Instagram, I see somebody with a music video, I hit them up. Hey, you know, you need some promo or something, man? Yeah. Like, we got all this shit going, real full-fledged radio station in here, so, you know
what
I'm saying?
It gotta be. It's like, the day of the interview is not the only day that we working. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's what some people don't understand. Like, it takes work. Like, we gotta do the research. We gotta prep the shows. You know what I'm saying? We gotta get everything set up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It takes a lot of work, and it's not hard. I mean, it's not easy, but at the end of the day, I love it.
And you know, I need to take her advice. I never research anybody. I just be freestyling.
I research the music. And then if I'm really on the artist, I watch the interviews already. And I kind of know what they're about a little bit. But I kind of, sometimes you like going into them and not knowing. Like I said,
I like to meet a person like right then and there. You know what I'm saying?
That's live too.
If I know too much, it's going to be crazy.
But on the other hand, he's the part of the team that's always reaching out to the artist constantly. Like, I don't do that like he does it. Like, he's on it like that. And so that's why we make a perfect team, because I do my research on it, whatever, get the show ready, and then he does that part.
Like, about the incident on your first interview, I had no idea. I didn't even know she knew about that.
Yeah, I didn't even know. I gotta see, because I don't even know how she even knew about that, but it's all good. You know, I did a lot of interviews, bro. This is probably like my 20th collab, you know what I'm saying, platform collab. So it's like, I've been trying to really run this up, and it's good, like, how we met organically, that, you know, we could actually tap in and come create, you know what I'm saying? Because, well, I be wanting to create with people, especially when people got a nice setup like this and a nice studio where they vibing and working.
Shout out to that boy G, man.
Shout out to Blue Sky Radio.
But even like the event that I met you at, you know what I'm saying? It was artists there, but like, you know what I'm saying? Like, just us being known media outlets, we get invited to stuff like that. Like, it's June 27th. And we sitting at the, what's that restaurant called?
Maestro's.
Maestro's in the Galleria. In the pandemic, we in there with Lil Flip, Big Mo Mama, the owners of Exotic Pop, TJ Ford, man, Hawk's son, Fat Pat's son, his Hawk wife. Like, it's like people that you knew about your whole life, and you sitting in a room with these people,
like,
able to talk to these people, like, nobody around you, and it's just organic, you know what I'm saying? So, like, pulling up to stuff like that, even being invited to stuff like that, it's like, not only did I meet artists, not only did I meet very legendary people, I met him, you know what I'm saying?
I was about to say that, even just meeting Big Ant, like, that's huge for me. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's like...
But I actually heard of you before I met you, though, you know what I'm saying? Because I think I followed, I might have followed you already on my personal page, because I've been really tapped into, like, people that be out here doing the same thing I do. I want to be aware of the competition. Not that I see y'all as competition, but I just want to know who, you know what I'm saying?
Who active. With. You got to know who active, dog. You got to know.
It got to be, bro. And it's, I feel like we should operate as a team, bro. This industry, like, we should keep collabing, getting together, bro. Connections from connections, like, we can all get up.
I like the friendly competition
at the table for everybody.
And see,
but obviously a friendly.
Well, see, that's the thing that I don't think people really get, and they didn't get it. I don't think you had that problem at all. Like I said, we met how we met and rocked how we rocked or whatever. But a lot of people think that, oh, it can only be one of us.
Yeah,
they think that, and bro, like, if y'all don't see what's going on, y'all not doing y'all research with New York. And Cali got 30 popping platforms where they getting money. They getting sponsors. Exactly. They getting advertising checks. They got teams over there with people. This is what they do for a living. You know what I'm saying? Houston can be that same way if everybody just work hard, build and build and build instead of looking at it like, oh, I can't fuck. And the artists got to understand that too. Don't just go to one platform. Like, some artists would think like, oh, well, I went over there with him, so
I went to the cert room, so now I'm loyal to that nigga.
Yeah, I can't go to that. I can't go over there.
Like, I don't even only do interviews on this. Like, I didn't really interview with all the other online radio stations too. Facts. I didn't know all of them. So
yeah, that's what I'm tapping in with.
They shouldn't feel like it would be an issue to begin with. You know what I'm saying? Like, we gotta put in that work, so they won't feel that bad.
And I done met some cool people, like the niggas that run Stay Down. Like, I ran into them at the Enclave. They cool niggas, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, that makes them inspire.
Enough Talk that we met the other night. They cool, they some cool.
I've been on there, I done worked with them,
They some cool niggas, you know what I'm saying? Bro, you just interviewed my homegirl, Faith and Hustle.
Okay, yeah, we tapped in, when it was, the other day?
Yeah.
Well, actually, she interviewed me.
Yeah.
But I'm going to go back over there and rock with them, and they look
fine. I met her at a Lil Flip album release party, and then she brought me on her show and did an interview. But, like, you know what I'm saying? That's a whole, at the time, I was rocking with the Court 94. That was, like, competition to their radio station. Still went over there.
The Court 94, I was supposed to try to go on them at one point. I don't know what they got going on now.
Man, I can't even.
Yeah, you was over there at one point?
I started over there.
Okay,
that's how I first got the opportunity to do the radio.
Okay.
Now they over there at Barron, but I'm banned from doing interviews at Barron. Like, I can record music there, but I cannot do interviews and podcasts.
Shout out to Young and Hustle and that interview that
Faith
you did. I mean, sorry, Faith and Hustle. My bad, and the interview that you did with her, because I seen it, like, I think it was yesterday, and it was pretty dope.
You seen it?
Yeah.
Did she put it up?
Yeah.
She
put the whole thing up? It's a little clip on
it. I saw the clip.
Okay. I gotta watch it. Yeah. She ain't tell me.
It's fire. I like her vibe. I like her style.
Okay.
I never knew of her until, like, you know,
yesterday. She cool people.
Yeah, she cool. She rocking. So, man, I really appreciate y'all tapping in, man. We rocking. We collaborating. We gonna keep pushing. Give them y'all Instagrams and how they can get in contact with y'all and everything.
So I'm at Brain So Poison on Instagram, at Brain So Foreign on Snapchat, and it is Poison with a Z, so get that right. And I'm Kiki Ure with the Red Light Boulevard Show, the Blue Sky Radio, Times of Syrup Room.
Okay.
And you know, I'm the Syrup Room, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to the rest of the Syrup Room, too. It's not just me, but I'm the one you probably gonna see the majority of the time, but... You know what I'm saying? You can follow me at the Syrup Room, like Syrup, like Sip and Drink. I know I can't say it right. I got an H-Town lingo. Yeah. But Syrup, like Sip and Drink Syrup, the Syrup Room underscore. You can find me the same name on there, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, all that.
And please stay tuned for this rebranding that we got going on.
You might see a new name pop up in a minute. I don't know.
Very, very soon.
So we locked in. We're going to tap in, man. 1,000. Appreciate y'all.
Yeah, I appreciate you, bro.
Appreciate you.